Alhamdulillah wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam ala that. So it's important for us as Muslims to be obedient to our parents and to maintain the ties of kinship, which means that we should try to always keep our family relationship strong. You should call on the telephone your mother if you're away from her, or your grandparents, or your aunts and uncles and so forth. So we should always try to maintain strong ties of relationship and the ties of kinship, regardless of whether our family is Muslim or non-Muslim. We should always try to maintain what? Strong ties. And in this regard, from the hadith of Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu قال, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحب أن يبسط له في رزقه وأن ينسى له في أثره فليسل رحمه أخرجه البخاري. وعن أبي جبير وعن جبير ابن مطعم رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يدخل الجنة قاطع يعني قاطع الرحم متفق عليه. In these two hadith, the hadith of Abi Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه and the hadith of Jubair ibn Mut'im. In the hadith of Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever loves for their life to be prolonged. And then some of the scholars say this means, a group of the scholars say that it means that your life will be longer or extended if you maintain the ties of kinship, meaning you're kind and gentle to all your family members. And you make sure you don't stay away from them, not contact them, and treat and mistreat them. So you should treat your relatives how? Treat them kindly and maintain the ties of kinship. So some of the scholars said that this means that your life will be extended. Another group of the scholars, they say that Allah will put barakah in your life. So the life that you do have, however long subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed it for, you will have blessing in your life. And what is barakah in your life? Barakah or blessings in your life means that Allah gives you tawfiq that you will do good deeds in your life. So those are the two different meanings that the scholars have deduced from that hadith. And then the last part of the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ ordered us with keeping the ties of kinship, that you should be kind and gentle to all of your elders, all of your family members. Try to make sure you contact them. Do not cut them off. If you have a fight or an argument with a cousin or someone, for example, try to at least maintain the ties of kinship. Try not to cut it off. In the other hadith, the hadith of Jubair ibn Mut'im, in this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Jubair ibn Mut'im radiallahu ta'ala, said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the person who cuts the ties of kinship will not enter paradise. So explain to me, after I describe this for you, what does it mean to cut the ties of kinship? What does it mean to you? Okay, good. That's good. So that means you should maintain your ties. That means you should always try to keep good relations with your family members. And does it matter if your family is Muslim or non-Muslim when it comes to keeping the ties of kinship? I think you forgot already. So I said there isn't a difference. That even if you have a non-Muslim relative, you should be respectful and keep the ties of kinship. You should not cut them off for any reason, for the sake, just because they have another religion than you, or you should not cut them off because of you've gotten in a personal argument with them. But if they disrespect you because of your Islam, because of Islam, then that's something different. Then in that case, then it is permissible for you to stay away from them in order to protect your honor and the honor of Islam. That if they're cursing Allah, they're cursing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they're doing things that are harmful to you and that are hurtful to you, you still try to keep nice with them. But if they're attacking you for your faith, then you won't be able to maintain strong ties with them. So as long as they're not attacking you for your faith, even if it's something personal, you still should try to maintain some good ties with them. You should still call them to Islam and call them to good. And I ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.